we're going to be discussing the topic of renunciation. And I'd like to read to you first from Swami Kriyananda's book, Affirmations for Self-Healing, on renunciation. So if you'd like to, you can close your eyes, sit up straight, and listen to these words. Renunciation means turning one's back on non-essentials, that we may give our whole attention to the Lord. We might think of renunciation as an investment, which initially may seem a loss, but in time becomes multiplied to many times its original worth. The least gift that we give to God will return to us in divine blessings a thousandfold. Renunciation means nothing less than the gift to God of oneself. Renunciation is of the heart. It isn't what you wear or the outward rules you follow. When you renounce all for God, you hold that renunciation as a precious secret between you and Him. All your desires, all your ambitions, then, are for Him alone. So in a little bit, we'll do our affirmation together and send out healing prayers. But I just wanted to talk for a moment about this beautiful topic of renunciation and how Swamiji describes it as renunciation being of the heart. It isn't, you know, that we've taken any formal vows or not. It's the vow is in the heart. It's that we've given our life to the divine quest, to the spiritual path. And it's not an easy path. It's a simple path, but it's not always easy. And nor should it be. Yogananda said that an easy life is not a victorious life. And it's in those challenges that we find our inner strength and that we learn then to share that strength with others as well. And we become stronger. We become rooted in that fearlessness of a spiritual warrior, knowing that nothing can kill our spirit. No one, no circumstance can take away our love for God. And so that's really the only thing we have to hold on to in life, is that divine love and that ability to choose happiness no matter what our outward circumstances in life. So I also wanted to talk for a moment about healing, because that's what our circle is all about, is becoming a purer and purer channel for divine energy to flow. And really, you can think of it in a simple way, that if you're, what you're focused on, there your energy is going to. So if you're working on being a healer, for example, and allowing divine energy to flow through you, if you're then in a situation where you'd like to, maybe there's an emergency situation and you'd like to be a channel for divine energy, but your mind is so scattered that you can't focus on the task at hand, how much energy then are we able to be a channel for? And really, this is why meditation is so essential to the healing arts, because we need to learn to focus. And we are being asked to be a channel for divine energy no matter what our occupation. And so the more that we can focus on everything that is put in front of us, the better we'll be as a divine channel. And as Yogananda said, the channel is blessed by that which flows through it. So on that note, I'd like for us to do our affirmation together. So take a moment, if you're not already, sit up straight, draw the shoulder blades back a little bit so you're opening in the heart, relax in the shoulders, relax the face. Feel that you're being drawn up through the crown of your head, that your spine is nice and straight and relaxed. Abdomen is relaxed. Take a few deep, slow inhalations. inhalations and exhalations through the nose, calming the body, the mind. You can visualize that the divine energy is flowing in through the medulla at the base of the brain. Flowing in there, the yogis call that the mouth of God. The divine energy flows into the body, and you can feel that energy flowing through your whole being. Feel it calming your whole body, your nervous system, your brain, your thoughts. Lift the gaze gently to the point between the eyebrows, as if you're gazing out at a mountain peak in the distance. And now let's take this affirmation first out loud. If you're able to, you can repeat it after me out loud, and then we'll gradually get softer and softer to a whisper, and then mentally repeating it. So this first level, the out loud conscious, it's grabbing the attention of the conscious mind, and then we take it into the subconscious, and then finally we broadcast it with the greatest focus at the point between the eyebrows, the superconscious level. So closing the eyes and repeat after me. I spurn the tempting magic of this world, with its rainbow bubbles ever ready to burst. See where I fly, high above the tall mountains. I am free. I am free. And now taking it a little softer, I spurn the tempting magic of this world, with its rainbow bubbles ever ready to burst. See where I fly, high above the tall mountains. I am free. I am free. And now in a whisper, bringing it into the subconscious, churning this affirmation, I spurn the tempting magic of this world, with its rainbow bubbles ever ready to burst. See where I fly, high above the tall mountains. I am free. I am free. And now silently broadcasting it with the deepest focus at the point between the eyebrows. I spurn the tempting magic of this world, with its rainbow bubbles ever ready to burst. See where I fly, high above the tall mountains. I am free. I am free. I am free. I am free. And pray silently with me. Lord, help me to see that in no outward experience will I ever find fulfillment. All that my heart has ever sought awaits me in Thee. And as you continue to meditate, begin to bring to mind anyone you know in need of healing. See them surrounded in divine light and love, in that cosmic vibration of Om. Visualize that cosmic sound bringing with it divine peace and joy, and permeating everyone you know, and continuing out blessing all souls in need everywhere. And let's pray together using Yogananda's healing prayer. Divine Mother, Thou art omnipresent. Thou art in all thy children. Manifest thy healing presence in all bodies, minds, and souls. And rubbing the palms together vigorously, drawing the love, the unconditional divine love from the heart into the palms of the hands. And then holding the hands upright, chanting Om three times for body, mind, and soul. You can stay here for a moment, continuing to radiate those blessings out. Feeling the divine energy flowing through you powerfully. And when you're ready, drawing the hands together in front of the heart, gently bowing the head. Offering up the ego, renouncing the little ego, offering it into the divine self, the infinite self. Om, peace, amen. Thank you for joining me. Have a beautiful rest of your evening.